So we are in Mapsa today, and this is McDonald's Business Systems, a place with a very Scottish name.
Yep.
And here's my friend Hubert McDonald.
Hi.
D'Souza.
Yes.
Why McDonald's?
McDonald's because...
A bit ugly.
McDonald's, I got this name McDonald's from Hyderabad, where I was actually born. And it so happened, the day I was to be baptized, my actual godfather didn't turn up. So my dad, who was in the railways, happened to just go out to the church because he wanted to finish up with the ceremony. And he met this Mr. McDonald.
Scottish guy.
Scottish guy. It was during the time when it was the Quit
India movement. Early 40s.
Exactly. No, this was in the 50s.
50s.
So he said, see, I won't be here. So I'm sorry, I can't. So my dad said, whatever it is, let's finish this ceremony. And that's how I got this.
So that's how McDonald's lives on in Goa. Of course, the Goan community in Hyderabad and Secunderabad, that's another chapter altogether.
Exactly.
And it was quite prominent at one stage.
In the railways.
Many Goans in the railways.
Yes.
And then some in pharma industry. I think those D'Souzas were
pharma,
there.
Pharma, D'Souza.
From Saligaon.
From Saligaon and from here also. From National Lab.
National Lab.
Exactly.
They had that that manufacturing plant.
Correct,
which
correct.
Was very popular all over the place.
And one Cordero, that's from Saligaon.
Yeah.
He had a pharmacy.
Okay.
Very famous.
I see. So, but we'll come back to McDonald's.
Yes.
Your range of services, Hubert, is cash transfers, driving licenses. What exactly?
Driving licenses. I give help in all sorts of things, even which is not my line.
Okay.
Because I give it to people as they need something.
Yeah.
Which they keep moving around and they can't find anymore. I say, come on, let's help out.
So mostly these are services that the expat community can use because of their absence from Goa or something like that? Not necessarily.
Not necessarily.
Okay. Okay. Tell us about your cash transfers. I've come here for a Western Union transfer.
Yes.
But what are the range of cash transfer services you offer apart from Western Union?
Now we offer Western Union. Besides that, we have RIA Money.
How you spell it?
RIA.
RIA. RIA Money.
Yes. And then we have transfers.
Okay. Okay.
Then we have MoneyGram.
MoneyGram.
Then we have Express Money.
Express Money.
All these products, they need the same system as we do it for Western Union.
Yeah.
And we strictly go by RBI rules where a PAN card is necessary.
Required, yeah.
And a photograph, recent photograph, and maybe any proof of address like the Aadhaar card, voter's card, driving license, or a passport.
And if it's above a certain amount, then they have to receive it via the bank check.
If we offer, because of the pandemic,
yeah,
we had a lot of problems and the bank was, you know, charging TDS and
okay.
all these things. So we decided from our own interest,
okay.
in our own interest, to help people. And we give up to 30,000 cash.
Okay.
And anything above 30, we offer them a check.
Interesting.
Which they have no problems. All our checks go through.
I see.
And people are very happy and that confidence is built. Oh, you go there, even if you get a big amount, don't worry.
Yeah.
They say that.
Hubert, as far as transfers go, what would you recommend? See, because Western Union and all work fine for a certain amount.
Correct.
But if it's small, it's a pain in
yes,
that sense. With a lot of paperwork and...
Yes, yes.
So what would you suggest as a best means to transfer money, if it is small, medium or big?
You mean to say through Western Union?
Through any option. What would you suggest, say?
See, the bank charges a big amount.
350 rupees commission.
But it depends upon the amount.
Yeah.
And people feel very, you know.
There are losses on the way and there are postal losses and other things.
Western Union or any other brand,
yeah,
it's very convenient for them and it's reasonable whatever they charge.
No, but my point is this, Hubert, to get an effective Western Union transfer, it should be at least like, you know, $50-$100 in that range. Otherwise, the commission is more than the transfer. No?
Exactly.
Say if I want to sell a book online, which is what I often do.
Yes, yes.
And then PayPal works, but there are some bureaucratic hassles with PayPal also.
This people find this way, this mode,
okay,
the best.
Okay.
because, and we especially in MAPSA, we don't create any problems. We make it very smooth.
MAPSA is a very big business town in that sense, and it always has that reputation of doing good business.
Yes, and it depends how you are. Now, we have been 35 years in line. Not in this, in advertising, and lots of people, it's a word of mouth that spreads and say, go there.
Yeah.
Because we don't do much publicity about what we do. Yeah. When they come here, and what else you do? Let us know. You see, they like to help in that way. And then we tell them, even sometimes we go out the way, some people are having very difficult problems sorting out for the passports. Though it's not our line.
But assistance.
I go out of it and I say, come, let's help you.
I see.
And in that, the word of mouth goes, you have your problem?
I see.
Because I go there, there's a lot of problems. The passport people don't.
They're not very cooperative.
No.
Things have changed a bit. Things have changed a bit now with the privatization and Tata's taking over.
Yes. But still, people, they don't feel very comfortable with the information they get. Say, for example, someone wants to get a new passport because he lost his previous passport. They're very rude there at the counter. And people today, this, in the songs of technology, they want to get things in a shortcut way. Means legal. But still,
people are in a hurry. People are always in a hurry, especially if you're traveling and moving.
Even for Western Union, if they go to the bank, they're never cooperative.
I see.
They're very rude. And here, the service that we render,
So you said 35 years back, you started in 85, 86, when?
Yes. My first business was the driving school.
McDonald's driving school.
Yes, that was the first in 1984.
You taught yourself?
I used to teach.
I see.
Because I wanted to teach them something different from the normal people that teach.
Yeah.
And it was just like how they teach in UK.
I see.
I was doing it that way. But what happened? The RTO would never appreciate my efforts, that they used to always say, oh, he's from out.
I see.
You know, they want to put you
down.
Yeah,
yeah.
But I never, I said, let me go on till I build up a certain clientele.
I see.
And then I'll go into my actual. And that's how all these other products
ancillary
came.
All meaning, can you list them?
The RTO.
Yeah.
Any problems of the RTO, all legal.
Yeah.
Then people having problems for passport, application, online, appointment, I do all that for them. And first I started in this way, that to help them out.
Right.
Then automatically people started saying, you go there, he'll help you.
I see.
And then it becomes like a...
So Hubert, the thing has, things have changed over the last 35 years in terms of money transfers and all. What, how has it changed? Has the quantum gone up? Has the efficiency grown? Computerization?
I have gone with the times.
Yeah.
In the beginning, it was not so much. But then with the technology and growing it, we had to go with it. Otherwise, you're out of business. So I have gone with it. And there's a lot of change now. But there is dirty competition.
I see.
Where they'll do anything to put you down and say, oh, I'll give you cheap, come to me.
Yeah.
But the quality is not as how I give it.
You moved to Goa in which year? Moved back to Goa?
I came in eight. As soon as I came, I started 84.
And your folks were out of Goa for how long? How many generations?
Year only.
No, you all had migrated to Hyderabad. How many generations?
Yes. Hyderabad, that was... Grandfather? My dad was in the railways.
Yeah.
And he preferred to be in one place for our education and all this.
Hyderabad was a good place for us.
Otherwise, what do you do when they get transferred in the railway?
Shift a full family.
He never took that. He says, no man, if I don't get promotion, at least my education of the children will be updated. And that's how we moved in 1969.
Out of Goa?
Out of Hyderabad.
Out of Hyderabad.
And we came down to Goa.
Okay.
But then it was
difficult. It's tough in those days. To get jobs in Goa and to even get into enterprise was very tough.
Then I moved.
Okay.
I waited for some time and I moved to the Gulf.
I see. Which part?
That was in Dubai.
I see.
And that time Dubai was very...
Small.
Small. You would still see Arabs going on the donkeys and all.
I see.
And I was doing my own business, like imports, re-export, all these things. And whatever came my way, I would go into that. Like construction. I'm not an engineer.
Yeah.
But then you can always do something
with
the help of those type of people.
If you have the knowledge and the intelligence, you can use it
and
in any field.
Then from 1978, when there was a recession in Dubai,
yeah.
I moved to Saudi Arabia.
Okay.
There I was there for another 8 years. And then I said, enough is enough. I should go back to my mom and dad, look after them. Because what's the use of money?
Correct.
I won't get them back.
Correct.
Again. And that's how I came to Goa in 84.
Very interesting. A photo of your card, just if you don't mind. I won't take it because I've taken any number of copies, but I'll
get it. Okay.
Yeah, fine. Yes. Your card, your visiting card, if you have one.
Oh, yeah.
Just for someone who might want to contact you.
Yes.
Of course, this is in the Gomes Kartown complex.
Yes.
No doubt. Which is.
Okay.
Yeah. This is fine. So your phone numbers are here for anyone who wants to see it. Gomes Kartown complex is almost like a small mini GMC in Mapsa, no? Goa Medical College. Your dad worked for which railways, if
railways,
I may ask?
For
South
Central Railway.
Central.
Central Railway in Hyderabad.
After independence?
Yes. No, he was there.
Before?
At Gandhi's time.
So what was it called in those days?
It was the Nizam Railway.
Nizam
of Hyderabad. And then the government took over the Nizam Railway. It was NSR. Nizam State Railway.
I see.
And then it became
South Central Railway, SCR.
Yes, South Central.
Which Goa was part of?
After that Goa, yes.
Yeah, after 61.
After
61. SCR, I remember that very clearly.
You had someone in Hyderabad then?
No, my mother's folks were in Hubli in the railways. Another railway town.
Yeah.
And we often say sometimes that we should write a book about railway stories by Goans, you know, because of course that generation has passed on.
Yeah.
But, you know, their families might remember the stories.
My dad took all the great people, like Nehru, special.
I see.
He was, he used to drive the engine.
I see.
And he took a
very risky
Nehru.
Job, no?
Yeah.
Can't
he was
A-grade
driver. Top. And he took Rajendra Prasad.
Wow.
Then he had Radhakrishna.
I see.
The president. Then Indira Gandhi.
Those days people still travelled by train, even the top big guns. It was only after that air and all came in,
exactly.
No? In that sense.
They always travelled by train.
People have written about Goans in the railways. I think, if I'm not mistaken, Hartman D'Souza.
Heard about Hartman, yes.
Yeah, who wrote a beautiful piece about some railway driver or something, and as remembered by his wife or something like that.
Okay.
There is a full series of stories waiting to be told, no?
Oh, yeah, I know.
And pictures and all. You have any pictures of your dad's times? That would be fascinating. Maybe
I have a picture of the engine with who he was there also, and I'll give it to you one day.
I see. Give it to me means I just want a scan or something like that.
Okay.
We should. No problem. Some other time.
I'll send it to you on WhatsApp.
Sure.
Huh?
Sure. Yeah, on some of the online networks, there are these Brit guys, mostly Brits.
Who are romanticizing
the Indian railways. And they have groups to discuss Indian railways and you know engines and which are still going strong.
And I was very fond of the engine. When my dad used to come in the railway station, I used to run and say, "Dad, I want to take the engine for a shot." They say, "Okay, my son, sit." I was small.
Yeah.
He said, "Okay, that's the regulator, that's the vacuum where you put the vacuum brakes."
Oh gosh.
And he used to be at the back.
At the side.
And I said,
"And this is which year? At what age?"
I was
50s.
I was only about 7 or 8 years old.
I see.
But I love the engine.
All boys.
We are all 6 sons, no daughters.
All boys dream about becoming a driver, bus driver. You could dream about becoming an engine driver. Thank you so much, Hubert. Hubert, fantastic. Thanks.
Thanks.
All the best. All the best.